show you kind of what we work on within that first week. So lots of undemanding time. We just spend lots of time where we just come in the stall or in their turnout and just rub on them, scratch them, help them get those itchy spots. This kind of helps build their trust in you. And so they're not always assuming you're going to do things to them, but you'll do things for them. So I've got the halter here today. So I'm going to put that on. Always come underneath. Slide it on up over his nose. He's not trying to see it. If he drifts at all, I'll just drift with him. Again, I'm not going to hold him with the halter because I don't want him to get worried or panicked about it right now. Just getting him used to the feel of having it on. On them, lots of rubbing again. Find those itchy spots, make it feel good. Have them be more focused on getting scratches than having that halter on his face. Once the halter's on, we're going to work on a little bit of guiding again. Again, I'm not going to ask him anything from the halter yet. I'm just going to get him used to moving off my body, moving the shoulders over, going forward when I ask him to go forward, and then eventually we'll start putting pressure on that halter. So to get him to start going forward, I'm going to put my hand on his bum here, a little bit of pressure, ask him to walk. If he starts walking, we can walk together. If he gets stuck at any point, I'm just going to come back, put a little bit of pressure. I want to be as light as possible. So I'm barely touching, just ask him to follow that heel forward. It might be a lot of start and go sometimes, but eventually their feet will get unlocked and they'll be able to walk with you. Again, we don't ask a whole lot of them at this stage. We just want to get them willing. We don't want to have the expectations too high because then they're not going to succeed. So we keep it realistic, just a little bit at a time. When he's got the forward figured out, we can walk together nicely. I just support him with my hand on his neck. We can do turns towards, so I walk into him. I ask him to yield out of my space. If he doesn't, he just kind of runs into my leg and runs into my hip. And then that'll teach him to get out of the way. And that's how the mums guide their foals. They just kind of walk through them and they figure out to stay out of mum's way. So it's something that comes naturally to them anyways. I can do turns away from him, where I want him to be able to turn with me and not leave me. When he's being good, he gets lots of rubs. Again, I'm not asking anything from the halter yet. It's just there, just to get him used to the feel of it. See, he's starting to pull there a little bit, so I'm going to turn the opposite direction of where he's pulling and ask him to stick with me. If he gets stuck, just ask him forward again. Lots of rubs for a good job. If they get too fast, you might have to do lots of turns or keep them on a circle because they'll try to get ahead of you a little bit. I'm lucky I've got long legs, so I can normally keep up with these foals. But every now and then, we've got one that likes to go fast. So if that's the case, I just turn them. I just keep them on a little circle like this. So I'll just keep one hand on their neck, one hand on their bum, keeping them forward and bending them around the circle. Got a little bit more control over them this way, so if they try to get too fast on me, I can just hug them here a little bit tighter so they can't get away on me. Get them walking. If he gets stuck, I'm going to see if I can start to unlock them by asking the front end to move now. So I've done lots of putting pressure on the bum. Now I'm going to see if I can get him to unlock forward by moving that front end. Anywhere he drifts, I'm going to drift with him. Just going to see. Shoulders until he thinks forward. A little bit of pressure away, a little bit of pressure towards, until the feet unlock. You might only get a step or two in the beginning, but that's a start. Again, just asking a little bit at a time. For him to move over, follow that feel. There, good boy. When he thinks forward, I reward and I rub. Stage three of leading, where you don't have to use the hand on the bum to guide them anymore. Sorry, stage three of guiding. So every now and then I can reinforce with that hand on the bum if he needs it, or I can unlock this front end by asking him to come left and right until he thinks forward. scratches right now. Again, just going to keep leaning here until he thinks forward. Once he thinks forward, I'll stop. Yeah, good boy. Lots of rubs for doing a good job. Turn. He gets stuck again. I'm going to just see if I can get that front end to unlock. Go forward. I'm going to step into him. You kind of push them over a little bit with your leg. There. Just very, very little. You just need one or two steps.
With them like this, just a few minutes at a time. You're just looking for them just to get a little bit better each time. Again, take this opportunity to rub them all over. Rub those legs, rub the belly. Short sessions, so 5-10 minutes here and there. Make sure you always spend extra time rubbing on them so that they, again, they don't always see you and think, oh no, I'm gonna have to do something. Sometimes you're just coming in to love on them, give them affection, build that relationship with them, build that trust. Some you're gonna have to work a little harder to get that trust and keep that trust. Others give it pretty willingly.
Scoop him up here. Turn myself so I can get to his other side. I'm just going to turn him over here a little bit so you can see me when I take his halter off. So again, I want him to be soft and relaxed when I take the halter off. He tries to eat it. So I'm going to undo the knot. I'm going to ask him to turn his nose into me. And then I'm just going to wait for him to settle here for a second. And then I'll slide it off his nose. Sometimes they'll get a little rushy. They know what happens next. Again, just ask them to soften in. When he's soft, I'll take it off. Then I'll rub everywhere the halter was. Make it really enjoyable. Again, they don't
don't always think that that halter's something bad. I know those itchy spots. He wants to leave me. I'm going to step away when he still wants a little bit more. They get a little silly. I just kind of hold them back, let them know that that's not appropriate with me. It's only natural for them to do. Go back and rub. Step away again. And I got a better approach. I do recommend having foals out with other foals. We usually wait until they're about a week old until we start turning them out with other foals, but they can take all that stupid energy out on each other. They can run and play and buck and do things that horses do. If they don't have that, they will turn to you because you become their playmate. Redirect him, I'll just push his nose away, and I'll just continually do that until I figure out that